Hi everyone, Ulysses here for Microchip Technology. Welcome back to Ask Our Experts, a series of videos where we answer some frequently asked questions on a wide variety of topics. Today's topic is on secure elements. To help answer our question, we welcome back Todd Slack. So, let's get to it. Todd, you were part of the Wireless Power Consortium working group focused on security. Can you explain the role of secure elements in the Qi 1.3 wireless charging specification for the cell phone market?
So to answer that, it probably makes sense to go back to the beginning. The Wireless Power Consortium is the organization that is responsible for the development of global specifications in order to unify specifications surrounding wireless charging protocols. So initially, when they released version 1.0 and ultimately 1.1, it supported a power level of up to 5 watts, which is now referred to as the baseline power profile. With the 5 watt limitation, the problem is you can imagine driving in a car, you place your phone on the wireless charging pad, and you have apps going like a music app, GPS, a number of other things. It can actually drain the battery at faster than that 5 watt charge can charge the phone. So even though you're sitting on the charger, you'll see that battery drain down. So with that, in 2015, the WPC introduced version 1.2 of the Qi spec with the extended power profile that goes up to 15 watts now. But at the time, it did not require any authentication. So with no authentication, you could end up placing your receiver or your cell phone on a poorly designed charger that is claiming to be Qi compliant but isn't, and actually cause damage to the cell phone itself. With cell phones costing $1,000+, that's certainly a problem. So to take care of that, the advent of Qi 1.3 has recently been released, and Qi 1.3 now requires hardware-based authentication. And so now, when you place a cell phone on the charger, it will initially accept either a 0-watt charge or a 5-watt charge, and then it would go through an X509-based authentication and challenge response, proving the source of the manufacturer and that it has been approved by the WPC or their accredited labs. And now, once you go through that authentication process, the cell phone would accept up to a 15-watt charge at this point, staying well ahead of the curve of what it burns down on its battery when you're using all of the applications at the same time. So in order to do that, there is also a supplemental spec, which is the authentication spec, which mandates that you have to select a good quality secure storage subsystem. Some might call that a secure element. In any event, you need to prove its security worthiness by submitting to a third party. One of the ways that you can prove security worthiness is to get a joint interpretation library score of Jill High, which is the highest score available, which our crypto authentication products and crypto automotive products have achieved. So we can support the silicon side of secure storage subsystems. The next important point is that you have to be licensed and routed back to the WPC Root Certificate Authority with that certificate chain. So provisioning comes into play here, which is why Microchip has become a licensed WPC Manufacturing Certificate Authority. So that allows us to submit certificate signing requests on behalf of our customers to the WPC Root, and allows us to get a Root certificate, a unique power transmitter manufacturer, a certificate, which is the manufacturing certificate, and then ultimately we can create independent and unique product level certificates, which would mean that every power transmitter on the market would have a unique ECC P256 key pair with an associated X509 certificate that roots all the way back to the WPC. So we've got you covered there. And then ultimately, we also have a full solution and one-stop shop, which includes our DSPIC 33C series to enable all of the charging applications. That comes with the Qi stack. We have the secure storage subsystem, things like the ECC 608 or the Trust Anchor 100. And then we have an associated cryptographic library that goes along with those, and then provisioning. And ultimately, we have approved reference designs available to make your life easier when you're designing a Qi 1.3 compliant power transmitter.
Thanks, Todd. Great explanation. For our viewers, make sure to check out our WPC Qi 1.3 reference design page linked in the description below. And as always, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be the first to know when we have more insights from our experts. We'll see you next time.